Liverpool klare for sin tredje Champions League-finale under Jørgen Klopp. Velkommen til pausepraten onsdag 4. mai ved Arve Vassbotten. Liverpool klare for finalen i Champions League for tredje gang siden 2018 og for tiende gang totalt. For Klopp blir det hans fjerde finale. Bare Marcello Lippi, Alex Ferguson og Carlo Ancelotti har klart det tidligere. Og Klopp var selvsagt strålende fornøyd etter semifinaleseieren.
Outstanding, massive, feels like it's the first, to be honest, because it's always so special. It's for me the best club competition in the world. Love it, love the sound, everything, love the night, what respect to Villarreal. This really wonderful stadium, what the people doing here is absolutely incredible. What Unai is doing, incredible. The players, how they put us under pressure, everything is great. So it feels so special because it was so difficult for us. In the end, we deserved it as well, and that's really cool. And it was massive, massive from the boys. So before the game, I told the boy I would like to have to read the headlines, which is that the mentality monsters were in town, just because I wanted us to be from the first moment, not that somebody who defends the result but goes for the 3 points or for the win. Couldn't see that, but the second half was like this. And I'm not 100% sure, but I asked what is in Spanish, and I think it's mentalitare monstruosos, something like that. But maybe somebody can figure it out. So for me, it was like this, because it was, you could see how impressed we were in the first half, and then coming back like we came back in the second half is really special. With 500 games, like it feels with the boys played, it's completely normal that a thing like in the first half can happen. But reacting like we reacted made it really special again, and that's I'm really happy about that.
Men etter første omgangen mot Villarreal var hele forspranget fra Anfield spist opp. Da Klopp kom inn til pause, ba han assistenten Peter Kravic finne et videoklipp av en situasjon der laget gjorde ting som de skulle i den første omgangen. Resultatet? Han fant ingenting.
Usually in a situation like this, when we don't find a way into the game, we try to find a situation which we can show the boys in a half time, which explains it a little bit, what we have to do. So when Pete went in, I told him, find one situation, just one situation where we did it how we wanted to do it in the first place. And when I came in, Pete just said, nah, didn't find any. But it was clear. So the start obviously was really difficult for us to take. We were obviously impressed by that. We had no real build-up. We didn't play in the right spaces. All of a sudden, we just kicked in long balls somewhere and tried to force it. If we had kind of a moment to play, then we were directly kind of dangerous, but never enough to get a little bit of momentum. So we just said, explain the boys where we have to play, what we have to do, where we have to be stronger, and how we have to move smarter, because we obviously in the first half, we didn't move enough. We couldn't find the midfielders in half space because they were not there. Front three were too fixed. Sadio left, more right, and Yoga in the center. There was no flexibility, nothing. So we had to mix that up, definitely, to cause them more problems because of their very man-orientated defending. We played in their hands, and that's what we had to change.
En av løsningene til Klopp var å sette inn Luis Diaz, men Klopp gjorde det klart at Diogo Jota ikke var noen syndebok her, selv om han ble tatt ut til pause.
We had 11 problems, if you want, in the first half, and we just had to mix it up, and you can do that with explaining what I did, obviously, but you need then fresh impulse as well. So it's just because it means so much. That's how it is, that it means so much. And all of a sudden we were not ourselves, but second half we were ourselves, and that's why we won the game. And yes, of course, Luis, what a goal, what a few more situations. Yeah, top performance.
Liverpool det fjerde laget til å nå 10 finaler i Europas gjeveste klubbturnering. Real Madrid med 16, AC Milan med 11 og Bayern München med 11 de andre. Onsdag kveld kan Real Madrid sikre seg en ny finale når de tar imot Manchester City på Santiago Bernabeu. Manchester City skal forsvare sin 4-3-ledelse fra første kamp. Vinneren møter altså Liverpool i Paris 28. mai. Du har akkurat lyttet til pausepraten det siste døgnet med Liverpool fra Liverpool Supporterklubb Norge. En nyhetssending som legges ut på alle hverdager. For flere nyheter, besøk liverpool.no.